I've told, we have 18 YouTubes that we know we have collected. We have instituted legal proceedings on them. I told Apple, be cutting their videos. Anyone that is saying nonsense about us, be cutting it. If you want to speak about me, speak the truth. You're attacking people. They didn't do this. Oh, they are not pastors. Who are you? Did you call me? You don't tell me how to run a church. You were not there when I started it. Your channel is 4 years, 5 years. You want to protect it at the detriment of a ministry that's 30 years.
There are more people to be arrested. These were the words of livid cleric Apostle Johnson Suleiman, leader of the Omega Fire Ministries. He said these to YouTubers who, according to him, defame and slander his reputation. Apostle Suleiman decided to institute legal action against any YouTuber speaking against him and his ministry. So far, the apostle has put to paid what he meant following the arrest, questioning, and detention of Israel Balogun, a YouTuber who reportedly slandered cleric on his miracle money service in the US recently.
Nigeria
man, another, is already in jail serving 7 years of a sentence, and another YouTuber also apologized for defaming the apostle. He took a swipe at those condemning and criticizing him for not attending the late prophet TB Joshua's funeral last June.
The YouTubers, the way they lie, even Satan is shocked. You just come up with something. A pastor died the other day in Lagos. When some of us heard the death, for 2 days we could not sleep. Me, I had pains in my chest. I went to mama's room. I said, why would this man die? I had pains. I had to start praying for myself because the news hit me. And I told myself, I need to start praying. How can you be a man of God? You're happy that a fellow man of God is dead. But to put it in the media, they are all happy. Who is happy? Pastor Chris Oyakhilome, for example, had a major crusade he had advertised on the date of the man's burial. I had a program here. People are coming from all over the world. We should abandon the program and go to a burial to make you happy. You know how many of our representatives we send there? But you just thought, oh, they are happy. They didn't attend. Who are you to tell me what's better to attend? Is ministry for your family meeting? It can be irritating. You see somebody whose opinion is never valued by his own family is coming online. You that cannot keep a home, you cannot keep a business, you are coming to tell us how to run church. What do you know?
Apostle Suleiman, who was also a former journalist, said anyone against miracle money was insulting God.
Now the problem now is they have is miracle money. If you talk against miracle money, you are insulting God. You are insulting God. That I will now arrange with people at my level. What am I looking for? Money, name, that I will now want to impress you. You that your own family said doesn't want to impress you. I will now want to impress you to make you happy. What am I looking for? I'm not hungry. I don't need fame. Popularity is a problem. It's not even good to be famous. Because once you are famous, you have no life.
He said God has asked him to seek justice with anyone who defames him.
During April, the Lord spoke to me. He said, anyone that comes after you on the media, get justice. I heard it from God. And we have gotten lawyers, even up to international criminal courts. Stop this. If you want to do business, let's talk. I'm saying that because don't be surprised. In fact, one of them, there's somebody that is in prison now. He has been given a sentence, 7 years. And they are calling me. I'm not saying anything. Another one just did an apology. We are not closing our mouth anymore because we are quiet. We are quiet and you are thinking it's now a culture. You just wake up, hey, have you heard again, oh, apostle, as you are saying that, prison.